information communication technologies, which plays a major role in any smart cities. To talk more about, we have Charulata Somal, the MD of KUIDFC. Ma'am, what is the necessity of having this kind of a conference, and what are the takeaways?
So one of the major takeaway from a conference like this is twofold. One is that there is a lot of knowledge exchange, because sometimes when we are in our organizations, we are quite caught up with the works and challenges within our organizations and our sphere of work, and then, you know, we come out and we see what is also happening in the same sector with the other. So that's knowledge sharing is one. And the second is to meet with like-minded individuals and agencies to explore scope for collaboration.
And also, data is very, very important. India is in a very nascent stage about data collection. How does it work?
Yes, so the thing with data is that the whole idea of data as of now is it's a very, very daunting challenge for us to collect data, to validate the data, and then to have the data out. And, you know, then in one of the presentations, you know, someone went deep into the various types of data. So we need to ensure that you know, the data is safe, the data is secure, and also that the data is accurate, that the data is updated, that the data is collected periodically. So there are many of these challenges. Some of the departments in the government have done very well on the data front, and then there are others where there is a lot of scope for improvement. And through KUIDFC also, we are in the process of identifying you know, to do a study with respect to where we stand in today's day and time with respect to data, and what is the gap that we have to fill. And the government of Karnataka is probably the first state government that has started already speaking about an urban observatory, where we talk about the use of big data feeding into policy and the use of data feeding into decision making. So again, as I said, it's a very ambitious project that we have. Nevertheless, it is achievable, and a lot of challenges that, you know, we will have to face one at a time and go ahead.
And also, coming back to smart cities, I mean, 5 years back, 100 cities was announced, and Karnataka has got 7 of them. So what is the status of Karnataka, ma'am? Because we read the reports that the funds have not been utilized properly. And what are the bottlenecks? What is the road ahead for KUIDFC? You have been the nodal agency.
Yes. So the observations that are done with respect to Karnataka smart cities is actually also equally applicable to all of the smart cities. And I would say that Karnataka, the cities of Karnataka, are doing rather well. And in the past 1.5 years or more, you know, we have picked up further. And it is something that has also been recognized nationally, the role of KUIDFC and the Urban Development Department for pushing the smart city initiative forward in Karnataka. And this has been done by putting certain systems in place. So we have ensured that there is delegation of powers, you know, there is delegation of administrative and technical and financial powers, so that we know how the various proposals and processes have to move, because government is also about procedure. We cannot ignore the procedure. So as long as we are able to put a system in place, and we of course have, you know, very dynamic chief secretary and principal secretary and ACS UDD also, and there has been a very there's been clarity of command, and everyone is working towards the same. So what is communicated at the level of the chief secretary is very clearly understood up to the city level and by all of the intermediaries. So it's a very focused approach that we have been following in terms of you know, moving our projects ahead and improving our progress. So yes, Karnataka has made a lot of progress, and our cities are only getting better at it. Thank you.
Ma'am, thanks for speaking to Smart Sustain, and I'll be tracking
sure,
most of the
class.
Yeah, thank you very much.